Just when you thought you understood global warming and its causes, a bit of a stunner. Conventional thinking has always been that forests help reduce the effects of carbon emissions. Tonight, an alarming study in the journal Nature says large tracts of Canadian woodlands will actually make the problem worse. This is the reason, the mountain pine beetle. It's been destroying vast areas of British Columbia pine forest for years now. And tonight, scientists say the decomposing wood left behind will emit millions of tons of carbon. Chris Brown now on the problem and why there's no easy fix.
The mountain pine beetle has chewed the life out of British Columbia's forests. Warmer winters have meant the beetle's march eastward has gone unchecked. A swath of trees twice the size of New Brunswick is already dead, and now it appears the destruction of the rice-sized bug will be felt across the continent.
But we estimate the impact of the beetle to be just under a billion tons of carbon dioxide emitted during the outbreak cycle, and that is equivalent roughly to five times the annual emissions from the transportation sector in Canada. So these are very big numbers.
Research scientist Werner Kurtz says forests usually purify the air by sucking up greenhouse gases, but in BC, he says the dead, dying pine forests are being turned into a vast source of CO2.
So what we have is a situation where climate makes the beetle worse, climate change makes the beetle worse, and yet the beetle is making climate change worse.
This forest near Nelson in southern BC is full of dead pine trees, and you can tell by the signature pitch tubes on this tree, it's been killed by the pine beetle. Not only can the trees no longer absorb CO2, they'll soon be rotting and decaying, pouring greenhouse gases back into the atmosphere.
Scientists have been aware of the beetle's potential to wreck local logging economies and to create ripe conditions for massive forest fires, but this is the first time the beetle's role as a pollutant has ever been quantified.
And I think it reinforces the need for us to reduce emissions from the fossil fuel sector, to see industrial regulations reduce those emissions as well.
Forestry companies are logging all they can to try to get rid of the dead wood, but they only cut what they can sell. And markets are slow, and crucially, trees are not being replanted fast enough, says this professional tree planter.
We're working from an old management regime that doesn't take into consideration this kind of catastrophe, and I think to some extent that it's amounted to the makings of a massive policy failure.
Well, we agree. That's why we increased the amount of planting that we were doing this year in the budget. We'll continue to do that, but it's not just a matter of saying, let's just go plant. You've got to plant the right trees in the right place.
The experts say the forests will recover, but the process will take decades. In the meantime, all those decaying trees will spew carbon into the atmosphere for years to come.